Kawasuma, and welcome back to a channel that doesn't exist. To a channel that doesn't exist. So today we're jumping back in Star Trek Online. Don't ask me why I am on Kobali Prime. And a little update from the last one. I finished the first contact day. And did I miss? Yeah, I missed it by a lot. So, launch toy rocket. This is how it looks like. And it flies up. Away it goes. I'm not gonna do the shuttle one because we're gonna get into the new feature episode. Weirdly enough, it didn't download in the launcher there. Either it didn't download or it downloaded very fast. So let's go. Featured series. Survivor. Play now. Okay. Wait. Let me go to episodes. Feature episode. Survivor. Starfleet Admiral T'nae was duplicated during a temporal incident. T'nae, if you remember, is the one you contact in the Romulan Mystery series. Until this has been resolved, the galactic timeline is in jeopardy. Like in the Iconian War? Really? Work with Agent Daniels to make things right. Contact Daniels, minimum rank Lieutenant Commander 10. Wait, what? Then why is Sela in here? The launch screen says hunt, begin the hunt for Sela. Join the hunt for Sela. Well, maybe I title this the hunt for Sela. Well, hail.
Some time ago, there was a temporal disruption involving the USS Enterprise C. We thought the matter was fully resolved, but there was an oversight.
Enemy target.
We need to find one of the Enterprise C survivors, a temporal duplicate of Starfleet Admiral T'nae. Until we reconcile the displacement of the timeline of the jet, there's one person in particular that can provide the location of this child, Sela Adronicus.
All right.
She's operating the Titan system. Meet me there to search for Sela.
Oh, no wonder. Sela, if you do not know, spoilers alert, is the daughter between a Romulan, a random Romulan, it was not disclosed in TNG, and Lieutenant Tasha Yar. When the Enterprise C went to the future, and it was a weird future, and Yar went back with the Enterprise C to the past, and the Enterprise C was destroyed, and the Romulans captured her, and then made it with her somehow, and you have Sela, Empress Sela. Ooh, Romulan operative. Well, we're gonna look at this later, and but Polaron, nah. I'm not gonna do Polaron next, except this. And just a moment. Yep, okay, sorry. Just doing a little checking. Okay, so make primary. Travel to a Sitor system in the Beta Quadrant in search for Sela. So let's beam to the ship and get out of Kobali. And it's weird, like, if we finish the entire storyline already, wouldn't we be transported to a map that doesn't have conflict? Like, we resolve the Vought War problem, and then the Delta Alliance is formed already, so Kobali Prime is still under Vought War attack. Well, let's get to the Beta Quadrant. Yeah, the Azuri Sector transwarp, and let's go. Loading Beta Quadrant. Oh, I still have an Azure Nebula. Okay, now let's see. That's the Sido system. Okay. Pull across. And disable astronomics. And if I remember my key binds right. Oh no. Which one was it? Alt F10. There we go. The cinematic view. Oh, that's a binary sun. There it is. We can see the rings of planet. Looks like a Jupiter. A Jupiter style planet. Oh, we're here, I think. Yep. And look at the people that are going through. So, let's fly. And system belt? Really? Okay, let's begin Survivor. Sorry if I knock things around because I'm currently doing a paper model. Survivor. Nah, I'm gonna give him a voice. Now entering the Sitor system. No sign of any ships on sensors, Romulan or otherwise. Admiral, Transporter Room 1 reports that Agent Daniels has just beamed in. Well, I assume we are on the bridge. Welcome aboard, Agent. What's your take on this, on all this?
If she's here, we'll need to draw her out. Sela is not easily found if she doesn't want to be. In the meantime, there's a structure on one of the larger asteroids, but the mineral content there is making long-range scanning difficult. I recommend we take a closer look.
What sort of structure?
Looks like a small base of some kind. Industrial, possibly military. Whatever it is, it's running at low power. We'll get a better idea at close range.
Aren't you from future and you know what happens? Loophole. Understood. Take us closer, Helm.
Our intel shows a lot of Romulan activity in this system, in Sela's name.
You don't know
the name?
Command
believes she's planning an assault of some
Daniels.
Kind and gathering tactical resources.
You don't know the name of your own helmsman? Well, that is clearly the facility. Okay. Looks like a mining
station.
This looks
like an abandoned Tal Shiar base. Or what's left of one.
Scan outposts. I'm not even directing your scan at it.
It looks like the interior has been stripped of anything useful over an extended period of time. This could be the work of Sela's forces. They've been... Wait! Picking up enemy contacts. Romulan ships decloaking!
Shields up, red alert! You don't sound like Daniels. Alright. I haven't been in ship what? Oh, I know I'm a dreadnought, and I'm supposed to be very tanky, but I don't quite know how to build all my ships. Ooh, wait, that's right. Helm, what are you doing? Come on.
Target shields have failed. Four shields failing.
Also, I'm not doing a torpedo build. I'm not using any torpedoes. Mines, yes, but all lasers. Not lasers, sorry. I used lasers in the Star Trek bit. All phasers. Because I can't get my ship like straight enough to fire off a torpedo. And putting in one more phaser.
They're disengaging.
Uh-huh. Putting in one more phaser port would be much more beneficial for
me. Those ships were older, but battle ready and in good repair. It's unusual of them to run so quickly. We should stay sharp. There's probably more of them out there waiting under cloak. In the meantime, we damaged their propulsion systems in the fight. They're leaking plasma.
Really, you don't sound like Daniels. I believe you're the voice actor, but it's like when they brought Tom Paris back for Captain. Is he Captain then? Captain Paris. In the first episode, he didn't sound like Paris at all. He didn't sound like Tom. But in the second episode, he was definitely Tom. Here is kind of the reverse. The front ones where you met Daniels first, he sounds like Daniels. Now, I don't see that. It could be he did a project and couldn't get back into the groove for Daniels. Oh well. I don't see how this... What? Helm, follow that plasma trail now.
As long as they keep leaking plasma, we can follow their trail. They're not trying to lose us. I've got a bad feeling about this.
Unidentified ship, you are trespassing in sovereign Romulan space, and you are outnumbered. Surrender now.
Excuse me, I think you're in Romulan Republic space, which is part of the Alliance which the Federation has free access to. Nice to see you too, Sela.
Oh, it's you again.
We're not here to fight, Sela. Stand down. You wait, how do you still have ships and followers?
No. You are still trespassing in my space, and I could use a new ship.
What? I'm sorry, what is the condition of your ship, Sela? Red alert, tactical, fire to disable only. We'll stay by the side. My god! That class of ship is larger than the Breen Dreadnought? How... I cannot remember the class name. But my god! How? Just how did Picard avoid any conflict with that monster? Oh, very helpful. Okay, yeah, so.
Hull integrity fine. Below 75%.
We'll cut to the chase and tell me what it is you want.
Information, specifically on the location of certain Talshia prisoners.
Ah, I'd wondered.
Seriously?
Fine. I'd wondered when you'd get around to looking for the Enterprise C survivors.
Where are they? Logical deduction, where are they? Tell me where they are now. We have the aggressive one, the b- blunt one and the Vulcan one. I'm gonna use the blunt one.
When the Enterprise C survivors were taken, my father agreed to let the rest of the crew live, so long as Lieutenant Yar served as his concubine. She was executed, but my father held to his word. I am aware of their location, but I will only take you there if you agree to bring me with you.
Oh. If you come with us, you agree to be arrested. No tricks.
And what assurances do I have that I won't simply be executed? I will not agree to my death.
We will make arrangements for incarceration, not execution.
If I agree to this, I will be held in house arrest, somewhere reasonably pleasant by my own standards. I will not be cut off from access to the outside world, and I will not be given any sort of death penalty. Further, you will allow my crew and their ships to go without harassment.
I'm pretty sure such arrangements can be made. Prepare to beam aboard. Erect the level 5 force field once she beams aboard and point phasers at her. I mean, welcome, Sela.
The survivors of the Enterprise C were sent to a Tal Shiar prison world. Set a course for the Pictet system. I shall make my way to the bridge of this quaint little ship.
What do you mean, quaint little ship? I am in a Breen dreadnought, you. I want to swear. Very well, Helm. Plot a course.
Course laid in for the Pictet system, Admiral. Ready to warp at your command.
Warp out. Sela. No. Why, Sela? Patching files? Okay. Yes. Unloading Pictet system.
I'm reading several Tholian ships on sensors, along with some unusual temporal fluctuations. Tholians dislike anything involving time travel. We should be cautious. If they think we're responsible, they may become hostile.
Oh, yes. Sela, this is Daniels. Daniels, this is Sela. Agreed. Anything you'd like to add, Sela?
This is the Pictet system, one of many worlds where the Tal Shiar would send assets important enough to keep, but not threatening enough to kill. Supplies to this world stopped when Hobus was destroyed. But the Enterprise C crew are proven survivors. I admit, the Tholians being here is new. Surely it won't be too difficult for you to handle.
Shields up. Helm, take us in. Ready phasers. Launch fighters. You know what, we should just hang back for a while, for about 30 seconds, to launch the other two of our fighters. So, how's it going with you all? I hope you all have a good night. So, any late night stories to tell? Well, 10 seconds left on our fighters. Let's go in. And yeah, this single ship.
Do not intrude. We anomaly will be eradicated. Leave now.
What anomaly? Oh, oh. Damn it.
Four shields failing. Target shields have failed.
I can't see.
Devastating our hull. Avoid flying into it if possible.
Oh, yeah. And they added a new graphic when there's something behind you, like it will outline your character. Look, now my ship has a white outline. Come on.
You are no match. Gandalf Greyhane.
Where are the nodes?
Four shields failing.
Something caused it to destabilize quickly. Not a good sign.
See, I don't build my ships very well. Balance shields. Oh, you're not a tree one? Or you just come out of cloak? Tired of these weapons.
Shield failing. Target shield has failed. Right shield failing.
Temporal anomaly. It was emitting high levels of tachyon radiation and chronotons before it dispersed. I'll need more data, but I think it was an unstable gateway into transdimensional space.
Transdimensional? Daniels, you're making this up as you go. I see.
Scan one. I want to see what they were so interested in.
You do not give orders on my ship, Sela.
My most sincere apologies. I am so used to command and to quick efficiency. I just thought perhaps it would be better if we continued with the mission before more Tholians show up. We can stand around and talk if you like.
Oh, okay. We will talk. Set a course for the anomaly. Sela, remember your place. There's a mosquito in here. Where? Ah. A short burst. It looked like bubbles.
Based on these readings, I believe I've found an origin point for these anomalies. They're coming from the planet below. I suggest sending an away team down to collect data.
Right, let's go down and... Wait, shields up! Tholians! Seriously? Made her fly faster before. Cuts your web. Damn that mosquito! Get away, shoo! How can I lose all my fighters? Ah, missed.
Right shield failing.
This mosquito is big. Oh.
All clear. We should check out the planet while we can.
Yes.
Signs of habitation, but there's a lot of temporal disturbances down there. They're making it hard to obtain a clear reading at this distance.
Let's go down for a closer look. Sela?
Assemble your most able crewmen and... My apologies. This is your ship. You give the orders.
Oh, did it change this dialogue? Indeed. Daniel, Sela, you're with me. Let's beam down and see what's happening. Two only... Oh well, I'm not gonna take a tactical officer because Natas is more than capable of taking down enemies. Her damage is high with the skills. Oh, command officers, my god. Patching files. Are they doing this now, really? Feature episode comes out, they just patch files on each map you're going into. Like, I am lucky because I can, my family can afford a...
We beam down into an open courtyard within what's left of the Tal Shiar prison. Doesn't look like it's been inhabited for some time. I'm reading a number of temporal anomalies nearby, but my tricorder's having trouble analyzing the data. We're going to need to get closer.
For a somewhat good internet connection, but other people might not understood.
The shipments of supplies stopped long ago. Anyone alive down here will have a hard time. I suppose that's too bad for Admiral T'nae.
Who said anything about Admiral T'nae?
That is what this is about, isn't it? There are two of her, and no one else. If you find her, I doubt she will be alive.
We're gonna search for her regardless. Sela, you shut your mouth. Yeah, I just wanted to do that. You see that? That was a tactical nuke.
This world
nuke.
Was abandoned by the Tal Shiar decades ago.
Wow.
I doubt there's anyone left. The survivors of the Enterprise C might have left personal items behind.
Hold on, can I go back and see? Exploring! Ooh, there's a field behind there. Yeah, then what are these crates all about? Okay, so... Oh, a data pad!
This datapad dates back to the late 23rd century. It lacks power, but it should work once it's recharged.
See if we can power it up. There could be useful data on it. Are we not gonna explore? Like, look at this. Yes, it's all ruins now and it's very plain, but... If there were more, like, artifacts, it would be a very nice archaeology site. My god. Examine data pad.
This place hasn't been inhabited for a while. Thing is, the Tricorder is giving a range of time from 3 months to 30 years. We're dealing with some serious temporal flux here.
That could be a problem. Let's keep moving. So what, you want us to get into that while it shoots lightning bolts of it? Hey, strike
That's
me.
That's one of the temporal anomalies. I wouldn't recommend entering its area of effect. From what I'm reading here, contact with the anomaly will do considerable damage to anything organic. That being said, I believe we can deal with this. Stand over there, and between the two of us, we should be able to nullify the anomaly.
Understood. Charge! Oh. I see. So it's not invisible wall. Ha 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 ha. It's all perfect. It's not ruined. Aren't you gonna say anything, Daniels?
Someone's been here recently. The Tricorder's picking up numerous signs of habitation in the area. By the look of things, someone stripped this area of all useful items and moved on.
We should move on then too. We need to find a way past the gates.
This gate appears to have been locked from the outside. Perhaps they knew about the anomaly but didn't have the means to handle it. Ah, there's a manual override over there near our beam down site. We can use it to open the gates.
And look at the minimap. Red dots. Control appears to be behind some gates and more temporal anomalies.
When we disrupted this anomaly, it seemed to fracture, forcing more anomalies into our timeline.
How convenient.
I think we might be able to use that to our benefit, though. I'll stay here and act as an anchor. Find the best spot and use your Tricorder to emit the dispersal pattern again. We should be able to push those bubbles away from the gate controls. If you get stuck, I'll be able to get you out of trouble.
I'll disperse the anomalies and make a path through the gate controls.
Oh, the gate controls are trapped within an anomaly. We'll have to disperse it to use them.
What? Why is there reset temporal bubbles? Oh, why am I running to? What?
Looks like some of the closed gateways are rusted now. Find another spot.
What the hell? You're making a maze?
I think I can see a clear path to the controls.
Aha. It just points to where
the gate's open. Try to disperse where you are. It should open an escape path for you.
Oh. Just points to where you need to go. So, what's the point? Cryptic, do better, please. Where's Daniels? Why are you standing there?
Excellent. The gate's open, and we can continue our search for T'nae. Well done. Before we move on, I've managed to bring the data pad online again. It might contain clues on what happened. Looks like it's a personal unit. The primary user is Lieutenant Tasha Yar of Starfleet.
Dun! Are you certain?
Give me that! The first entry dates to 2389, nearly 40 years after she was executed. Or at least 40 years after she was supposed to have been executed.
Let's see the entry.
I am Natasha Yar, Security Chief for the Federation Starship Enterprise D. At least, that's who I was. For the past 40 years, I've been Tal Shiar prisoner 24601. But even that changed a week ago. Our regular supply drops from the Star Empire stopped 3 months ago. The guards started caring too much about what might be going on elsewhere in the Quadrant and caring too little about their prisoners. We were able to overpower them.
What are you wearing? What uniform is that? Oh, prison
managed
uniform.
To recover some data pads like this one, but there isn't enough here for us to call for help or escape. I'm leaving this record in case anyone comes looking for us. Sela, if you find this, I still love you. I've missed you.
Aww. But hey, you're the same voice actor.
Lieutenant Yar was supposed to have been executed. My father said it happened. There were witnesses. How can... Clearly, there was some judicious alteration of history.
So it would appear.
The Enterprise C survivors were here, but something drove them away. Something more than the loss of supplies. We should continue looking for the survivors. Your duplicate of T'nae may yet be alive on this rock.
Your father lied to you.
It would not have been the first time. No doubt he thought she might still have been useful in some way. I can see the pity in your eyes. Keep it. His decision allowed me to become the person I am. I do not regret that.
Yeah, I'm gonna go the passionate route. I just think it might be hard to hear now. Tasha was alive all this time.
Look, there's a path ahead.
Thank you, Daniels. Like, I have no eyes to see. I must say, it's beautiful. So why are we supposed to fight?
This anomaly looks more stable than the others. It's probably less deadly, but let's not find out now.
Talarian Hulk Spider? You guys really have... That's a Romulan data pad.
Generators died and no one knows why. Richard thinks it might have been the big predators. T'nae thinks she might be able to salvage some of the parts. I hope she can. She's been glaring over the remains for the last 3 hours. Two more dead. We can't stay here. The animals know the fence won't harm them anymore. I rigged an early warning system using a trick I learned growing up under Kona 4, but that won't stop them. Took a vote, and we're moving. We'll build a new settlement in the old secondary supply bunker the Tal Shiar abandoned 20 years ago. The surviving guard has agreed to guide us there. Loyalty to the Tal Shiar fades. You've been stranded with the inmates.
Huh. Tal Shiar. Sela. Sela, get your ass up here. Don't move behind me.
Lieutenant Yar never discussed Turkana 4. When I was older, I discovered why. She was a survivor. It is clear that her arrangement with my father was just that. Obviously, she continued that trait into her existence here. There's no ground to cover.
Indeed. Let's keep following the path. Do you cut your hair, Sela?
There's another unstable anomaly.
Obvious Daniel. I'll call you.
The anomaly has left some of the rock in a molten state.
You took readings in orbit. Surely we should continue looking. Clearly, these anomalies must be connected to your mission. Now, while you take a leisurely stroll through the jungle, I will be moving on. It appears that there are more survivors than initially believed.
On that, we're in agreement. Let's keep searching. Oh, cutscene.
There's a lot of interference, but I think I'm picking up a life sign.
Duh!
T'nae!
Go away! Leave this place!
Yes, T'nae? You have a stun grenade after all this time? Really? Hey, how about a fight with you with a Vulcan? I don't know what this is called. Vulcan Lerpa.
No, no! Please, not again! Stay away! Stay away!
Oh, Cryptic has upped their game! The interactions are all cutscenes now. Wait. Ops.
It seems your duplicate T'nae is still alive, and she isn't pleased to see you. I don't really blame her. I wasn't exactly thrilled to see you again either.
Shut up, Sela! I see a structure ahead. Let's check it out.
She's run off, but there's an even larger anomaly close by.
She's...
Another temporal anomaly, and this one is larger than the last. There are temporal eddies moving through the area, and a few stable locations between them. Now, if you establish temporal stabilizers in these three locations, we can disperse the anomaly and get a better look at the area. Hopefully, the Enterprise C survivors were able to escape the area before this happened.
Understood. Wait, what caused this? I don't remember in the Romulan arc about T'nae speaking of a clone of herself. And what? How did we even contact Daniels? Are we supposed to go in?
There's a stable pocket ahead of you. Set up the first stabilizer there. That's the first.
It looks like it was a structure at one point, but I doubt any survivors would remain in a ruin like this.
The system.
Incredible! Dispersing the anomaly restored more than I expected.
What?
We should look for clues.
Yeah.
He found an entire grove of saplings. Richard swears the same area was full of towering trees last week. He might be mistaken. We're both getting older. I thought I saw a Romulan in the brush. He was wearing a 22nd century style uniform. When I looked again, he was gone. Maybe I'm going senile. Richard insists I'm too young. It's because the outside world has been on my mind. Sela has been on my mind. I wonder what happened to her. While her father was a Tal Shiar general, he spared my life in the end. Perhaps he wasn't petty and cruel to her. I hope he wasn't. If you should find this, happy 50th birthday, Sela. I have missed you. I only regret we were separated.
First, 50th? She's that old? Second... why do you make Tasha such an emotional character? Sela? You might want to see this. Are you Sela?
Shelter ruined. last try, quarter gone, half our stores destroyed, 5 dead. The hunters and gatherers returned to find many dead and unconscious. I used my emergency medic training, but I was a security officer, not a doctor. Devek might not make it. None of them can remember what happened. Without the tricorder, we can't scan the area or for internal injuries. I suspect that there is something on the planet causing anomalies of some kind. T'nae has not reacted well. She's been talking to herself and keeping apart from everyone. A problem for later. Survival now.
Really? But... Cryptic, was it wise to bring back Tasha? Saying that she did not die all this time.
Some sort of temporal inversion happened here. Some of the rock returned to an earlier molten state, while some of the building materials aged over 200 years. Anyone standing close to these objects would have been affected as well, regressed to infancy, or aged to the grave.
Same thing could happen to us if we're not careful. Like Daniels, would you step close to one of them and maybe die of old age, you know? Huh? Sela.
Well, I suppose it was nice that Yar thought of me, but that doesn't change the fact that she was going to steal me away like a thief in the night. If she had truly cared, she would have stayed where she was. My father was not cruel or petty, at least not to me. He was hard because he needed to be. I thrived because of it.
Well, if that's the character you want, I see.
The Enterprise C survivors were surprisingly resilient. Tasha's notes are more sparse, but seem to record a productive, if primitive, community. They mention a secondary site close by. If your Vulcan survived, there may be others. And they may be close.
We should keep looking.
Over here! There's a path with recent footprints.
What? Examine tracks. Wow.
I'm reading another anomaly. Further down the path. T'nae might be there.
Tolians. Wait, how? Then how did T'nae get past them?
The T'nae anomaly and its allies must be purged.
I don't remember Tolians being
that
so tough.
That Tolian away team must have beamed down to investigate the anomalies.
Huh? Where? It's wet for some reason?
This looks to be a well-worn path.
No shit, Sherlock.
Some recent footprints here, heading the other way. They might have run into Tholians.
Seems your Vulcan passed this way recently. Perhaps the cavern mentioned Natasha's logs is nearby. We should follow the tracks.
They're headed towards those rocks.
It seems many of the refugees would be alive if it weren't for the anomalies. I wonder how many are left.
I'm detecting signs of recent habitation in this location.
Maybe we'll find more answers.
Wait, what? How am I supposed to... I can go inside on the inside. Nope. Scan? You want me to go outside and scan? Walao.
This was some sort of dwelling up until a few months ago. If I'm reading this right, there was an explosion of tetrion particles here. A fatal one, judging by the organic residue on the walls. No one's been living here since, according to these tricorder readings.
Understood. Let's keep searching. It may have left something behind. Yeah, like those data pads that we found.
Anomalies are temporal in origin. I watched Richard wither and die before my eyes. An anomaly appeared, and moments later, he aged 100 years. We buried him this morning in the clearing. I never expected he and I would end this way. I miss him. Richard was a wonderful partner for these last decades, a good man. Wonderful life, despite it all. My only regret is that Sela never got to know how kind and brave Richard was. He'd have been such a wonderful stepfather. T'nae hasn't been seen in days. I'm worried she won't come back. I'm worried she will. I thought her strange behavior might be a degenerative Vulcan sickness, but she was answering questions before they were asked, and she's been close to every anomaly that's happened. Maybe I'm jumping in shadows. The part of me that is still a security officer on the Enterprise doesn't think I am, though.
Yeah, the writing a bit weird. I don't think after 60, 70 years on the planet, you would still think yourself as a Starfleet officer back on the Enterprise. No.
This is T'nae. I have agreed to report the final words of Natasha Yar and to hold this log in the future. If there is one, if it isn't here already, I... What? No! Focus. Focus. Natasha Yar. Died of a fever. She wished for the story of the crew of the Enterprise C to be remembered. They were brave beyond expectation. She wished for her daughter to know that she was loved and that Natasha lived a long and happy life. But Natasha missed her, and she hoped her daughter's life was wonderful. Natasha requests that if this log is found, that this record be conveyed to Sela of Romulus and to the Federation. Do not come near me. End.
Well, we can see where this cave leads, Admiral. T'nae may be close by, and we need to find her before those anomalies get worse.
Agreed. Let's proceed through this cave and continue our search. Sela, you wanna read that?
Not cave, the tunnel.
I think I see movement in the bushes.
T'nae?
Stop following me!
I'll just snipe you from far.
Personal shield losing power.
Wow, you got knockback resist, matching files. Come on. Oh, I have to press it.
No. Go away. I told you to stay away.
Come with me. We'll be able to fix everything.
I am dangerous. You should not be here. No one can be here. No. Not again.
Not again? What do you mean?
No, not again!
There's a new anomaly forming.
She's the cause of the anomalies?
Folians!
Oh, seriously. Holy hell, those are a lot of people. Why am I doing this? I am not helping.
T'nae, the anomalies that have been occurring were caused by decades of temporal interference. Because of what happened with the Enterprise C, you exist in two places at once. We can fix this. You and your counterpart can be reintegrated. Your memories will be integrated as well, but the anomalies will stop.
We can help you. You don't have to run anymore.
I see the logic in your presence here. I am anomalous. My presence here must be sufficiently reconciled to preserve the order of things. I presume you are here to accomplish this. Thus, I will go with you.
We'll fix this, T'nae. You don't have to hide any longer. Admiral, there's something you should see. I scanned the area for Tholians after the last attack. While I didn't find any, I picked up something else. Judging by these readings, I believe I found the remains of the Enterprise C crew. Understood, let's confirm this after I pick up that sweet loot. Ah, really? What are you? What a beautiful tree. Oh, don't tell me that tree grew off Tasha Yar. Oh, you're gonna dump it on us like that? Graves? There's only one grave here.
All this time, she was here. I believe she was dead. Tasha believed I might come looking for her. She believed it so strongly she left logs in case. T'nae held her logs for her. And now, she is truly dead.
I'm sorry.
This place has led to some interesting revelations, shall we say? I think it best we leave before more Tholians show up.
Agreed. Prince Rogers are standing by, Admiral. We're ready to beam everyone up on your order. Beam up. Oh, you're just gonna dump that on us? Oh, my god.
Looks like we beamed up just in time. Several Tholian ships are on an attack vector.
Are you serious? Got a rail alert, all hands battle stations. Oh my god, you came out.
Ship is under attack.
We won't do what you will not. We will repair time.
Shut up, Tholians.
Right shield failing.
Wait, how do you get up?
Rear shield failing.
Last time I fight Tholians, you got massive armadas coming in.
Something is happening. It's happening again. Another anomaly is forming.
Prepare for battle. It's not over yet. Of course. Why would it be over?
Target shield has failed.
Oh, you're the smaller ships. Yes. Get closer. Get within 5 kilometers. That's an anomaly. That's a gravity well that you can actually shoot if you have a science specification for that, lah. Oh, that's the anomaly. I'm sorry. Sorry, law. Pasta? Oh, really? When do you come in?
Admiral, we're being hailed by the USS Pastak. It's Admiral T'nae. That is to say, the Admiral T'nae from our timeline.
Acknowledge, put it on screen.
I see you found my displaced temporal counterpart. Well done.
Thank you, Admiral.
An operations team is standing by on this vessel to assist with her temporal reintegration. Please beam her aboard, and we will begin the process. It is possible that I may acquire a new set of memories as part of the process. A small price to pay to stabilize the timeline. As it has been said, the needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few, or the one.
Admiral, I also have Sela on board.
I see. Having read the briefing from Starfleet Command, I find her presence here to be most logical, considering the situation.
She's agreed to go into custody now that the issue's been resolved.
Very well. I will take custody of Sela and deliver her to a secure facility once the reintegration procedure is complete. Beam her aboard with my temporal counterpart.
As you wish, Admiral. Congress G out.
It seems our journey is at a parting of the ways once more.
Yes, and I believe we'll meet you again. You escape your facility and all that blah blah blah. So it seems you did agree to place yourself into custody, however.
I did, and I will. But I have a condition to my surrender.
Bring it up with the Admiral.
All decks have reported in, Admiral. We're ready to depart the system on your command.
Warp out. Wait, what? Who are you? Data? No! No!
Tell me about my mother.
Data! Oh my god! They're bringing Brent Spiner back! Why are we in a soul system? What's that huge ship? Oh really, you stole the name Picard? Vulcus Temporal Dreadnought Orbit? What? Never seen that before. Oh please tell me they're gonna bring back Brent Spiner for Data. Please, 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 please. Because if you've seen The Next Generation, you would know that Data is the only one to have the holo projection of Tasha Yar. They were close, as he said in the episode, they were close friends and intimate, so to speak. Wait, what? You don't have a voice? Okay. The timeline is stabilizing. Anomaly counts are dropping and our agents are reporting a decline in temporal aftershocks due to the recent events. That's a good thing, by the way. The aftershocks of our recent discoveries on Pictae may take some time for Sela to resolve, however. I hope she's able to find a sense of peace and closure from what she's learned today. I'll be heading back to Temporal Command once we've fully integrated the two T'nae's. Be seeing you. I don't have a stealth. Yeah, I'ma give this to one of my bridge officers. Oh my god, so... Wow! Really? They brought Data. They brought him back. Overall, it was a review of the episode. So, I don't think that it was a good tie-in to the current events, say the Temporal Cold War and such, dealing with Daniels. And I don't remember T'nae speaking of any clones of her. Can I say clones? Clones of her in any of the interactions. Or maybe it's that I did not. Yeah, I finished the Romulan Mystery except for Darkness Before Dawn. But what? I don't remember T'nae speaking of any clones of her existing. And it's like Sela, yes. So I assume that Cryptic will bring her back again as the recurring villain, like how Dukat was. What happened to Dukat? Oh, he died in the fire caves. But too sudden, and it feels like a one-off episode instead of tying into the overarching story. It was okay. There were feeling moments when about Tasha. But the writing I don't think the writing was top notch. And in the end, that surprise, Data. Oh, I hope the next feature episode they bring Data back. Unless this is really a one-off episode. Well, wait, I'm gonna research a bit. There, here's one post warning spoilers. Sela's arrogance was ridiculous. This post is in the forums of the Star Trek Online main page by Mushroom Ridkali. Warning spoilers, story. Sela's arrogance was ridiculous. Yes, she should have known better. That is right, blah blah blah, against Vulcan. Yeah, at least she agreed to be put into custody after I ruined a tiny fleet and flagship. I didn't like that we didn't even try to enter dialogue with the Iconians at any point. Wait, what? The mission objective was immediately to blow them up. No Federation attempt at negotiation. What? Iconians? I don't get it. I think the transition from hardcore Sela that doesn't care for her mother to some sentimentality about her death was not very smooth and thus felt forced. Yes, yes. I'm not sure how much that is due to the dialogue. And how much that is to Dennis's voice acting. Yeah, I don't feel it. I have no idea how Tasha could really say she had a full life on that anomaly-ridden planet, though that might be because we only see the low points when people died. Basically, we missed most of the decades she was there. For a moment, I thought you might use the time travel shenanigans to youngify the alternate timeline Tasha, yeah, so we can finally close the chapter on Sela and put her into prison for good, but keep Denise Crosby around. Oh, really? Riddles. A bit too simplistic and thus pointless overall? Yes! Yes, the anomaly maze was pointless at all. Was too pointless. It pointed to where you should go. What I liked was that you could actually enter those dangerous bubbles and tank the anomaly damage for a while, allowing a more brute force approach to success. Yes, I did that. Nice callback. That's Data giving her the hollow, right? Yeah. Because he's the last I remember even having one. But that's not actually Tasha Ya, that was Sela's mother. You're right, that's not the Tasha Ya. The Tasha Ya that was Sela's mother was in an alternate universe. Oh, nice analyzing. Well, it's been more than 1 hour now, so. Oh wait, there's another one. Nice callback, that one. I thought that too, but Data was destroyed in Nemesis, so maybe B4? I don't know. Oh, I don't know about Data, maybe Ambassador Picard, that uniform looked more and like an official uniform than civilian wear, because Data, no, that one is what's the last episode of TNG called? I forgot. I'm supposed to be pro at this. But that's an alternate universe. The actual universe is Data died, ma, in Nemesis, and the strange body they found on that desert planet was activated to take Data's place. Data was brought back in B4's body. See path to 2409. The needs of the many countdown. Oh yeah, maybe I should go back and play. Yeah. Yeah, from novels. Yeah, okay, maybe I'm gonna dig deeper, but I'm not gonna drag this episode out, so thank you for watching. Leave a like and subscribe, and stay tuned for more. Goodbye.